1. Introduction.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey there.
You, sitting
in the dark.
Welcome.
Welcome
to this feature
in 16 parts.
A hexadecahedron of sorts.
Alive with many faces
and numerous narratives.
Galore.
Mesmeric.
Intertwined.
Yet also,
on occasion,
highly irregular in form.
A little unusual.
Slash eclectic.
Oh, and
didn't we say
somewhat
weighted down
with heavy storm?
Yes, we said storm.
A storm of storms.
The storm of storms.
Skies lit up.
Air made ragged.
In the
year without summer.
The
year of the beggar.
The year of
1800 and frozen to death.
Shiver, shiver. Now some of our 16s
we'll clearly
spell out,
but some we'll
kind of
forget.
Just allow them to
drift off
out of
sight
into
the
ether.
A lot like certain histories
forgotten.
A lot like certain people
forgotten.
A lot like the clouds 2 centuries ago,
all fluffed up to start with,
but soon pendulous with gloom,
carefully keeping their true natures hidden,
concealing their downcast looks
and brooding ways.
Just
off
to
block
out
the
sun,
dear.
Back
in
time
for
tea.
So, look and listen hard.
Oh dear one.
Sat there cozy
in the dark.
Engage your lenses
and your listening tools.
Stay alert. Stay alert.
Notice what's missing.
What's just off to the side.
Dancing quietly
in between our words.
Try and catch our drift.
Albeit a
tad
disjointed.
For
it
is
happening.
And
it
is
here.
And
it
is
unraveling
as
we
speak.
Yes.
It
is happening.
And
it
is
here.
And
it
is
unraveling
as we speak.
One.
Introduction.
Two.
What's that smell?
Three.
Oh.
So we must be witches.
Four.
Here are some thoughts flowing like lava.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur fell into a pit, into the earth, into our hair and nails, into our skin, and deep into our guts.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur belched in some brackish mud, helping a bunch of tiny organisms with cousins in the salty seas to make rainfall easier, which in turn fed plants, eventually eaten by us.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur tumbled out of a volcano, was found by a small girl, taken home, and accidentally dropped on the fire. Burning weirdly and with a strange smell, her alchemist uncle watched smitten and transfixed.
Someday, some time ago, on an island not too far away, a kind of weird magnetic attraction was at play, pulling nails with hands and hair with heads towards a still and slumbering sulfur.
Someday, some time ago, an industrial revolution unfolded. So, deep underground, way too hot for clothes, naked miners with picks and sledgehammers made small enslaved boys, who earned nothing but bent-over bodies, carry yellow rock upwards and outwards in the nearest thing to hell.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur paired up with charcoal and potassium nitrate, an explosive combination. It wasn't long before everybody wanted a bit of the trio, to shoot up into the sky or at a body or two, or simply to place at the base of some impenetrable rock and blow it to smithereens.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur started to attract tourists, drawing them in like moths to a flame, to snap photos and marvel loudly at the biblical fug, not really noticing the workers with heavy baskets and flimsy hanky-covered mouths as they trudged past, eyes streaming.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur got into a bit of a glut. Wherever coal, oil and petrol was, it seemed sulfur was too, just hanging out for everyone to see, as a vast powdery yellow mountain or a neat pyramid of bricks. But what about all the untapped profits? Thought industry anxiously.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur was recognised as something other. Brimstone. And not in a nice, affectionate way. More as a kind of an insult, full of hell, fury, and foreboding, and a prediction of things to come.
Some days, some time ago, as a kind of joke, a missile was also christened Brimstone. An upgrade of the Hellfire, this new one was Fire and Forget, which, according to the Prime Minister, was much better, as he addressed all of the MPs in the House of Commons, as they prepared to cast their votes.
Some day, some time ago, sulfur started coming out of mouths, as a word heads of state and pundits would say when throwing insults at each other, to sway votes and cause outrage, comparing each other to Beelzebub, or Satan, or the devil.
Some day, some time ago, sulfur got everyone hooked on one compound or another by being a vital nutrient to anything living and being used in just about every industrial process, such as in the making of fertilizers, fireworks, sugar, paints, medicines, cosmetics, petroleum products, detergents, dyes, insecticides, disinfectants, plastics, steel, storage batteries, shampoos, paper, matches, explosives.
Someday, some time ago, sulfur came into contact with some rubber. This was just excellent, according to Mr. Goodyear, who took note of the chemistry between them and quickly coated a wheel. Soon, everyone had a bicycle, then a motor car, then smog, then respiratory problems. All thanks to a process called vulcanization, named after the Roman god of fire, Vulcan.
Vulcan?
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 Volcano?
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 Volcano.
Volcano. Volcano.
Volcano is exploding.
Rock is shooting up. It's hot.
There is dense steam and ash and poisonous gases in the air.
Lava too.
Pyroclastic streams flow into the sea and there's dust everywhere. It's hard to see.
Help! Tsunami! Huge waves! A violent whirlwind! Our world is ending! It's apocalyptic! Help! Red alert! Yellowstone! Remember us! Remember us!
Six. Sorry, we didn't remember you. Instead, we remembered the year without summer.
It was 1816.
A year after the volcano.
It was sodden.
Wet.
There were continuous gales.
Widespread flooding.
And rumbling lit up storms.
It was cold.
Dark.
Trees were ripped from their roots.
There were out-of-season frosts.
Snows.
There was no food.
Nothing could grow.
In Europe, the sun wasn't seen for nearly 3 years.
Not just one.
No clear days recorded.
None at all.
In the UK, there were riots.
Bread or blood. Bread or blood.
In Switzerland, there was starvation everywhere you turned.
In India, aside from famine, there were relentless cholera outbreaks because of having no monsoon 1 year or too much rain in the other.
In the Arctic, temporarily, there was little or absolutely no ice in the sea.
A bit like now, but now it's permanent.
In Ireland, there was starvation and migration. An early warning of the more well-known potato famine soon to come.
And just as bad.
Inspired by the dense skies.
And protected by their wealth.
Lord Byron wrote the poem Darkness. Mary Shelley conjured up Frankenstein.
And J.M.W. Turner painted spectacular after spectacular ash and sulfate-induced sunset.
It was only 200 years ago.
It was a climactic breakdown.
There were riots. There was famine. You name it, the works.
Everything tipped up. Worldwide. The world over.
Nothing could grow.
It was a real-life case study.
A reminder of the fragile balance resting gently between all of the natural systems of the world.
All it took was for one volcano to send sulfur stratospheric.
And everything tipped up. Worldwide. The world over.
One.
Introduction.
Two.
What's that smell?
Three.
Oh.
So we must be witches.
Four.
Here are some thoughts flowing like lava.
Five.
Fear and trembling on April 10th.
Six.
Sorry, we didn't remember you. Instead, we remembered the year without summer.
Seven.
Sunset dance.
Eight.
At a kind of tipping point.
So, let's have some jokes!
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Endangered species.
Endangered species who?
Boom boom! Knock knock.
Who's there?
Ken.
Ken who?
Can we stop global warming? Why can you never trust atoms?
I don't know.
Why can you never trust atoms?
They make up everything. Why are chemists great for solving problems?
I don't know.
Why are chemists great for solving problems?
They have all the solutions. What did the boy volcano say to the girl volcano?
I don't know.
What did the boy volcano say to the girl volcano?
I lava you! How do sulfur and oxygen communicate?
I don't know.
How do sulfur and oxygen communicate?
A cell phone!
9.
Oh my god, we've been possessed by sulfur!
10.
We need some answers, and we need them quick.
11. A careful list of questions leading us delicately towards the point. What do you think the future might hold? Is the end of the world yellow? Can we grow food from ash? Can you find love in ash? What was before sulfur? Was brimstone shooting down from hell or a volcano? Is sulfur evil? What is your favorite shade of yellow? Do women smell sulfurous? Do women have special powers? Are you imagining us naked? Could the first chemists have been women? What does hell feel like? Real hell. True hell. How does one prepare for a catastrophe? Is it all down to sulfur? Is it all down to humans? What part of a 16-sided polyhedron is the hex? If I hex you, will you do what I say? Which part of a sunset is the sulfate, and which bit is the ash? Do you think all the supreme songs were prophetic? When the apocalypse comes, who will be protected? Who will write poetry and horror novels and paint landscape paintings? Will it help if our message is catchy? Will it help if we stand here and sing? Are the minds that the tiny parts our mobile phones are from as horrific and corrupt as the sulfur mines in Sicily were? Shouldn't we feel more ashamed? Does the E number sunset yellow actually contain sulfur?
Why do we all think sunsets are beautiful rather than musing on the chemistry at play? Why are cycles so important? What can you grow in your belly? Are you imagining us naked again? What exactly is an atomic number? Why aren't we all polymaths? Why is everything so compartmentalized? Why is progress usually built on the back of those less fortunate? Aren't you frightened? What can we do to make it better? Why is anything that can't be seen so easy to ignore, easy to overlook? Should we all stop inventing things for a while so we can just take stock? Did you know that the large crater formed after a volcano explodes and then collapses is called a caldera? And that caldera means cauldron. And that a cauldron is a very large, round metal pot used for cooking up soups and spells over a roaring fire. Are the stories we're telling the wrong stories? In too many ways, with too many bits missing. Like this story, the story of sulfur, which we knew once, but seem to have forgotten. Well, bits of it, anyway. That volcanoes produce sulfur. That parts of us are sulfur too. That we're all made up of the same basic building blocks. That we're kind of related. It's too hard to take in, isn't it? That our bag of bones bodies are just collections of molecules. The same things that make up that seat that you're sat on. Or the phytoplankton in the sea, without which the White Cliffs of Dover wouldn't be white. that a volcano could maybe just be thought of as quite a scary, fierce aunt. Shouldn't knowing this make us behave with more care towards our cousins, the auditorium seats, our grandmother, the watery seas, our great-grandmother, the skies? Are the stories we're telling the wrong stories?
Or is this the only way we know how? Making it up as we go along. Like this story, the story of Sulphur. Spoken of in Sanskrit, science labs, ancient books and tomes, at the pulpit, in the boardroom, out in Canada's mine-pocked Alberta tar sands. Through so many special isms, it's become difficult to get close to, difficult to recall, let alone see, what it's got to do with us. Or me. And me! What even is it exactly? Have we even shown you a bit? And how do you say it? Sulphur? An element, you say? And what exactly does that entail? We've forgotten, it seems, how anything connects, how everything connects. To us, to you, to the clothes we wear, the food we eat, the chair you're sat in, the invisible air we all breathe. Familiar, yet forgotten. Lived, but unlearned. Our intertwining, our relationship with the elements. This fragile balance resting gently between us. This fragile balance resting gently between us. This delicate holding, those gossamer wings. This moment. This sulphurous time of ours. This delicate holding resting gently between us.
Twelve. This is a climactic breakdown. 13. I will sing you a song that is a lament for the future. 14. The willow is weeping because the world is inflamed. 15.
So this is a love story between us and sulphur.
Perhaps instead that's where we should have begun.
What?
If we were to
tell
you
that it was a
feeling
ling
in our bellies,
ding-a-ling,
that first drew
us
towards sulphur.
What? If we were to
tell
you
that
we were
pulled
close
and
drawn in,
ting-a-ling,
before
we
knew
a thing,
thing-a-thing
about
s
sulphur. Sulphur.
It was
sulphur.
A feeling in our bellies.
Like butterflies were in our bellies.
Delicately evolving in our bellies.
What?
If we were to
tell
you
that
we
didn't
think
twice
when
our
lips
lipstick to lips were being kissed softly
by
S's
cargo ship
stacks.
That
it
took
a while
before
we
really knew
about
the
trails and tracks
left
in
the
wake awake
of
our
kiss
in
the
ocean. All
that
S
could
before
we
learnt we'd
have
to
change
and act.
Not
just once
or twice,
but
always, and
forever,
ever.
It was a feeling in our bellies.
Like something was growing in our bellies.
Connecting us to everything beyond our bellies.
We're
talking
years.
Like
really
back,
and
maybe
still there's
things
to
come
in the
future
to
learn
about
s
S and S.
There's
so
much
we
still
don't
know or know
are yet to
find
out
as
the
years
pass, which gives us butterflies in our bellies,
delicate wings in our bellies,
a cloudless self
in our bellies, in our bellies, in our bellies.
One.
Introduction.
Two.
What's that smell?
Three.
Oh.
So we must be witches.
Four.
Here are some thoughts flowing like lava.
Five.
Fear and trembling on April 10th.
Six.
Sorry,
we didn't remember you.
Instead, we remembered a year without summer.
Seven.
Sunset dance.
Eight.
At a kind of tipping point.
So let's have some jokes.
Nine.
Oh my God. We've been possessed by sulfur.
Ten.
We need some answers and we need them quick.
11.
A careful list of questions leading us delicately to the point.
12.
This is a climactic breakdown.
13.
I will sing you a song that is a lament for the future.
14.
The willow is weeping because the world is inflamed.
15.
So, this is a love story between us and sulfur?
Perhaps instead that's where we should have begun.
16.
The end.